at Excel Further Mathematics, FP1 from January 2012. Question 1 asked me to find the argument of Z1, and it's given me the number Z1, 1 minus I. Now, you may have learnt a formula for arguments, but I think it's much more important to understand what it's asking you. So if we just very quickly draw an argand diagram, the real component obviously goes along, and the imaginary component on the vertical axis. So the point 1 minus I is 1 across and 1 down. So there we have it. And the argument is the angle made with the line. Now we can see there that we have a right angle triangle. It's just asking us to find the angle in that right angle triangle. So I'm just going to draw it this way up for a second. It's an isosceles triangle, so obviously the angles are equal here. And without actually using the trig button on your calculator, you should be able to say that the argument of Z1 equals 45 degrees. You could, of course, use the arctangent button on your calculator. But just remember that the angle is measured clockwise is, that's anticlockwise. Anticlockwise is positive, and clockwise is negative. So it would be minus 45 degrees. It didn't stipulate degrees or radians, and in fact the mark scheme clearly says it accepts both. It's a two-mark question. It's a method mark for considering the right angle triangle using arctangent, or the fact that I said it was isosceles, and an accuracy mark for the answer of minus 45 degrees. In part B of this question, we're asked to find the product of Z1, Z2. So, quite simply, we need to multiply these things out. So Z1 is 1 minus I, and Z2 is 3 plus 4, right? And you just multiply these out like you would any other brackets. And feel free, you know, if you still draw the lines, to do so. Anything that helps. So we've got 3 plus 4i minus 3i, and then this will be minus 4i squared. I'm sure you can do this in your head. We're just going to take our time. So plus 4i minus 3i is just plus I. And then I squared is the same as minus 1. So of course you can see all of this becomes plus 4, and so we have the answer 7 plus I. Done. Nice and easy. Again, a two-mark question. It's a method mark if it's clear you're multiplying out those brackets, and it's an accuracy mark for the answer, 7 plus I. And finally, I'm asked to work out Z2 divided by Z1. Now, this involves an extra step, and that's why it's worth an extra mark. So let's just set out what that is. It's 3 plus 4i, all divided by 1 minus I. You can't do division in the way we'd normally do this, so we set it out as a fraction, and then we rationalise this. In other words, we times the denominator by the complex conjugate, so it has the opposite imaginary part. Of course, we can't just change the number like that, so we have to times top and bottom by that complex conjugate. So just take our time, show all our steps. Let's multiply out the top, so we get 3 plus 3i plus 4i plus 4i squared. And that's all going to be divided by, show all your work, and even if you know what this becomes, it's 1 plus i minus I squared. Okay? On the top there, you can see that because I squared becomes minus 1, this all becomes minus 4. So 3 minus 4 is minus 1 plus 7i, and that's all divided by, well, these cancel out, and I squared is minus 1. So this is minus minus 1, which becomes plus 1. So we have divided by 2. It's told us to write it in that form, so let's just give our final answer now. This equals, well, the real part of that is minus 1/2, and the imaginary part is clearly plus 7 upon 2i. And we're done. Okay, 3 marks. Why is it worth the extra mark? Well, there's a method mark if it's clear you knew that you had to rationalise it. There was an accuracy mark for getting that number 2 on the bottom, believe it or not, and an accuracy mark for the whole correct answer. Nice and easy. You need to know how to manipulate complex numbers algebraically. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please do share it using the link. I'm always upset when people find these videos the night before the exam, so do your friends a favour, put this on your Facebook wall, and they'll thank you for helping them. I want to help you, so do get in touch on Twitter or Facebook. You can request any videos, and of course you'll stay updated with all of the tutorials that I do. Good luck in your examinations. I really hope I've helped.